Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known as Bright Shine. I live here in the city of Memphis, state of Tennessee, in the county of Shelby. And today's date is early Sunday morning, July the 12th, 2015, the time 3:10 a.m. I want to first say thank you to all my fans, my support, for your continued encouragement and your support. I continue to keep myself employed at a company right in this area, Chip Panic Manager at 17 Ventura Drive in South Haven, Mississippi. I'm continuing to further my education at Monroe College Online. I'm pursuing my associate's degree studying business administration with a concentration in marketing. And I'm continuing to work on my entertainment interest as well as my musical interest. And I want to make sure I don't forget to give a big shout out to the Hewlett Law Firm. I continue to stay in constant contact with the Hewlett Law Firm. They continue to consult with me. They continue to give me sound legal advice on this legal matter that we are addressing. And thank them for helping me to hold my sound studio and Carlos William Hegel by the name Luba accountable and responsible in a court of law. Holding them accountable and responsible in a court of law. And that's what's been done already with my sound studio in the process of doing the same thing with Carlos Williams. He got by the name of Luke, but we had already started on him early in the year. And like I said, you know, sometimes individuals, including my sound studio, you know, individuals have this notion in their mind, they assume you can't find them. You understand? They assume you can't find them. You know, they'll sit around and do all this criminal stuff and they commit all these illegal acts. And then they'll sit around and assume that you can't find them. Yeah. The investigators will find them. You're not hard to find. You're not that smart. And everybody else is that dumb. Like I said, to all my family, my support, give a big shout out to the Hewlett Law Firm for all the help they've been providing. Excuse me. And, like I said, also, excuse me. On today's video, we're going to continue to talk about African traditional religion. And as we know, that when you teach African traditional religion, there's a standard. You understand? There's a standard when you teach African traditional religion. And also, there's a standard when you study African traditional religion. And so that's what we don't want to be confused about. You know, sometimes, including myself, I purchased some books that some people had written. And when you read these books, they be about African traditional religion. Or when you read a paper that one of our professors, doctors had written. But we know, like we said, there's a standard in teaching African traditional religion. There's a standard in studying African traditional religion. There's a method. You understand? So we don't want to be confused when you have people who've never gone to college. Some people never even attended high school. You understand? Some people have attended high school. And they didn't get a high school diploma. They got a GED. Then there are other people who have attended high school but dropped out. They don't have a high school diploma, don't have no GED, they don't have no general education diploma. They don't have a GED, they dropped out for whatever reason. Then there are people in junior high school who didn't make it past junior high school. Then there are people who made it, but didn't get no further elementary school. You understand? They didn't get past elementary. And then there are some more people. There are people who have never been formally educated, period. They have never gone to school. not even kindergarten. You know what I'm saying? The first grade, second grade, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth grade. The grade that's before the first grade is the kindergarten class, the daycare. They ain't never even had a daycare. They ain't never had kindergarten. They ain't never even been to a daycare. You understand? So when we talk about teaching African traditional religion, giving instruction in African traditional religion, when we say we're going to study African traditional religion, there's a method. In teaching instruction in African traditional religion, there's a method. In studying, and you learn African traditional religion. You understand? And what I want to do today, and I'm gonna do the same on my new video, is that when we was talking about the email, it was something that I didn't put no emphasis on at that moment. Because at that moment, I was putting more emphasis on the reply. Because I had sent an email, and when I sent the email, it was a question that I had asked, and when the professor emailed me back, that was what I was putting more emphasis on, the reply. But what I want to emphasize today is the professor and the Department of Religion. And when you study African, when we talk about African traditional religion, when you give instruction, when you teach African traditional religion, when you study, when you learn African traditional religion, that's part of it. Because when you, that's a big influence on myself and on others. It's when you hear the name of the professor. When you hear the professor's name. Let me refer back. And then we're going to refer to the papers that they wrote. As you know, I got a laptop in the house. We got down, you know, we got a desktop. So I had to move everything around. So when I be on the keyboard, I don't want no anybody. Don't think I know, because I do not know how to type. I be using my fingers. I do not know how to type. Like I said, when I sent the email, my emphasis was on when I asked the question. You know, when I asked the professor a question, I would like to know, can I study African traditional living online at the University of Calabar or another university or college in Nigeria or another African university or college in another African nation? That's the email that I sent to Reverend Dr. Enrique C. Ikiki. And, you know, of course, he emailed me back saying, thanks for your inquiry. University of Calabar does not currently run an online program, but they do teach African traditional religion, but they don't run an online program that way you could, you know, for you to learn African traditional religion online at the University of Calabar. But you can study African traditional religion as an online program in National Open University of Nigeria. You can access their website on this URL. Now, that's the emphasis that I was placed when I sent the email. But when we talk about who this person is, Reverend Enrique C. Ikiki, let's refer to the paper that he wrote. And like I say, I sent the email to Reverend Dr. Enrique C. Ikiki. He left his email address on the paper that he co-wrote with Dr. Chike A. Ikiapere. Now, we have an Enrique C. Ikiki. He's a lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies, University of Calabar, in the Cross River State of Nigeria. And then he left his email address. So I sent him an email. Now, he's a lecturer, but also Dr. Chike A. Ikiapere is the senior lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies. So, in the Department of Religious Studies, did you pay attention to the name, to his last name? Did he change his name to Muhammad Ali, an Afro-Asiatic name? But he's a lecturer. Both of these men are lecturers in the Department of Religious Studies. Did they change their name to Muhammad Ali? To Akbar Rahim? Or down in the Caribbean, did they change their name to some Amharic name? The Rastafari. And the Amharic people, they are Afro-Asiatic. And the people that's in Jamaica who were brought over here on the slave ship from West Africa, they are not Afro-Asiatic. They didn't bring no Afro-Asiatic on the boat. in the transatlantic slave trade. They didn't bring any Nilo-Saharans over here in the slave trade, in the transatlantic slave trade. Those are the slave traders, the Afro-Asiatic and the Nilo-Saharans. Those are the slave traders. So when you hear the name Reverend Dr. Emeka C. Ekiki, do that sound like an Afro-Asian? Do that even sound like a Nilo-Saharan name? Dr. TKA Ikeopero. What kind of name is that? That's not no Afro-Asiatic name. Or is it? Is that Hase? That Bodhi? What's that? Is that a Kushite name over in Somalia? Is that one of those Omotic names over in Ethiopia? See, when you study African traditional religion, that's part of study. See, that get people's attention. And then you be like, I wonder why so many people are becoming more interested because of the name Reverend Emeka C. Ekiki, Dr. Chike A. Ikeopero. That's influence. That's a big influence on me, on myself. That influenced me about African traditional religion. And it influences a whole lot of other people. When you talk about, you a lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies, because you know and I know they teach Islam in these religious studies in the Department of Religion. So when you see these professors and they don't change their name and they teach African traditional religion and you don't hear the name Muhammad Ali or some other Afro-Asian name, or you don't hear any Nilo-Saharan name, you understand? See, that get people's attention. Because we know that the Niger Congo was sent to the Western Hemisphere from West Africa and from Bantu land. So when you see a Nilo-Saharan, when you see the Afro-Asiatic, see, we know who the slave traders are because we know about the Arab slave trade. So we know who the slave traders are. We know about the Jewish slave trade. So that's the reason why we have Niger Congo. The Bantu people living in India, the Sidis are living in India, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan. You see all these Niger Congo people. See, when they hear about these papers that these doctors need professors wrote, it influences them. It's an influence on them as well. When they hear Reverend Dr. Emeka C. Ekiki, a lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies at the University of Calabar, Cross River State, Nigeria. And then Dr. Chike A. Ikeopero, the senior lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies, University of Calabar. Calabar, Cross River State, Nigeria. That influences me and influences the people that's in India who are Niger Congo because of the Arab slave trade, the East African slave trade, the transatlantic slave trade. You understand? See, that influences people when you talk about the Department of Religious Studies. Let's go to I sent an email to Dr. Joseph Sirwan Jibinda. He has a PhD, Department of Religion and Philosophy, Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria. Did you hear his name? Let me repeat his name again. He wrote the paper, The Impact of Colonialism on African Indigenous Religion, by Joseph Sirwan Jabena, PhD, Dr. Joseph Sirwan Jabena, Department of Religion and Philosophy, Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria. Now, I sent him an email, and I asked him a question. I would like to know if I could study African traditional religion online at Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria, when I earn my associate's degree. And he sent me an email back. He replied. He said, "Thank you for your email and interest. We don't have online program in African traditional religion for now." You hear that? African traditional religion. He sent an email. See, I asked a specific question. I would like to know if I could study African traditional religion online at Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria. See, I was specific. And then he replied with a specific reply. "We don't have online program in African traditional religion for now." Then let's go back to his name. His name is Joseph Sirwan Jabena. Jabena. You know, G-B-E-N-D-A. Jabena. PhD, Doctor. Department of Religion and Philosophy. The Department of Religion and Philosophy. Did you hear his name? Did he say Muhammad Ali? Did he say Raheem Mecca? No, he didn't. Did you hear a Hebrew name for all those Hebrew Israelites walking around, all those black Hebrew Israelites walking around? Did you hear the name Yahweh? See, that's Afro-Asiatic. But see, you need to get your history right. See, the people that came to the Western Hemisphere, Niger Congo. So when you speak Niger Congo, name all the groups that are Niger Congo. The Wolo, the Fulani. See, we get into the languages. The Upper Volta, Lower Volta, Adome, Yoruba, Igbo, Sango in the Central African Republic, the Sango. We go down to the Great Lakes, we are Kikuyu, Bantu. We go to Bantu land, we go in the Great Lakes area. In Kenya, the Kikuyu. See, in West Africa, the Mandi. See, did you hear Afro-Asiatic? See, this is where we get into the Niger Congo. Did you hear a Nilo-Saharan name? Joseph Sirwan Jabena. In Makurdi, Nigeria, Benue State, Makurdi, Nigeria. See, the Department of Religion and Philosophy, did he change his name? Did you hear Raheem? Did you hear Mecca? Whatever, you know, whatever they changed their name to. Muhammad Ali. No, you didn't. See, that's an influence on me and on everybody else that's listening. See, there are people living all over this planet because of the East African slave trade, the Arab slave trade, and because of the West African slave trade, the transatlantic slave trade. Living all over this planet. And when they see this video, when they listen to this video, they're going to be influenced by the name Joseph Sirwan Jabena. They're going to be influenced because the Department of Religion and Philosophy, Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria. And then they're going to remember that I sent an email, and he specifically, I asked a specific question, and I got a specific reply. See, they teach African traditional religion, because you know why? because Dr. Joseph Sirwan Jabendang has a PhD. He has a PhD in what department? Department of Religion and Philosophy. So what is he teaching over there? Is he teaching Islam? Is he teaching Judaism? No, he's teaching African traditional religion. See, they just don't have an online program. I'm gonna refer to another email that I sent. Okay. I sent another email to Dr. Chinwe Mainwoyi. Dr. Chinwe Mainwoyi, former lecturer, Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies, Kenyatta University, Nairobi, Kenya. Nairobi, Kenya. So I sent an email. She left her email address on the paper that she wrote, and I asked a specific question. Let me make sure I show everybody the papers that the doctors wrote. Remember, we were talking about Reverend Dr. Emeka C. Akiki and Dr. Chike A. Ike Para. They both lecturers in the Department of Religious Studies, University of Calabar, in Cross River State, Nigeria. They both co-wrote a paper titled God, Divinities, and Spirits in African Traditional Religious Ontology. Because he is a doctor, he does have a PhD. Reverend Emeka C. Akiki also wrote a paper, African Traditional Religion and Conceptual and Philosophical Analysis. Then Dr. Joseph Sirwan Jabinde, Jabinda Jabinde, Department of Religion and Philosophy, Benue State University, Makurdi, Nigeria. He wrote the paper, The Impact of Colonialism on African Indigenous Religion. Now, like I said, we're talking about Dr. Chinwe Mainwuyi. She wrote the paper, Dominance of the Trappings of African Traditional Religion in African Magic Movies, a Challenge for Educating the Christian Youth. Dr. Chinwe Mainwuyi is a former lecturer, Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies, Kenyatta University, Nairobi, Kenya. Little background she left in her paper that she wrote, she left a background, you know, profile. Dr. Chinwe Mainwuyi was until recently a lecturer in the Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies, Kenyatta University, Nairobi, Kenya, where she obtained her PhD. She's a woman. Dr. Chinwe Mainwuyi is a woman, was until recently a lecturer in the department. She was a lecturer in the Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies, Kenyatta University, Nairobi, Kenya, where she obtained her PhD focusing on definitional ceremonies in Igbo religion. She holds degrees in both philosophy and theology from Pontifical University of St. Thomas Aquinas, Rome, Italy, and a Master of Arts degree and postgraduate diploma in education from the University of Jos, Nigeria. And they said she resides with her family in Dodoma, Tanzania, East Africa. And she left her email address. So I looked at the email address and I sent her an email. And I asked her a specific question. I would like to know if I could study African traditional religion online at Kenyatta University, Nairobi, Kenya, or at another university or college in sub-Saharan Africa. She sent a reply back giving me a specific answer to my question. And she said, thank you for so much for your letter of inquiry, Honor, but I am pleased to know that you are interested in studying African traditional religion online in any university in sub-Saharan Africa. My answer to your question is yes, in a university where you can apply to study African traditional religion online is the University of South Africa. University of South Africa, Johannesburg, South Africa. To get access to them direct, you need to search online for the University of South Africa online degree programs. She answered, I asked a specific question. She sent a specific reply back. Did you hear her name? Her name was Dr. Chinwe Mainwuyi. Did you hear her name say Khadija Muhammad? Whatever one of them Afro and women, Afro Asiatic names, Marion, from Marion, all that Afro Asiatic, Nilo Sahara. You understand? Did you hear Nilo Sahara name? No, you didn't. You're in Niger Congo. Nigel Congo, Mandy, Molo, Fulani. You understand? And all of Yaruba, Igbo, Adome, Bantu. You understand? That's what you hear. That's an influence on me. And it's an influence on other Niger Congo living outside the continent of Africa, even on the continent of Africa. That's an influence. When you say the Department of Religious Studies, the Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies. You understand? Because there's we're talking about the people that email, but I'm finished on these down on these papers that these doctors wrote, it was the same thing. Joseph Omosani Awolelu, Dr. Joseph Omosani Awolelu. He wrote the paper, "What is African Traditional Religion?" And, now, in the notes on the paper that Dr. Joseph Omosani Awolelu wrote, it tells you in the editorial note, Dr. Joseph Omosani Awolelu is senior lecturer. He's the senior lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies, University of Abidjan, Nigeria, and has specialized in the field of the African traditional religion. He specialized. African tradition. And what was his name? Dr. Joseph Omosani Awolelu. Did you hear Muhammad Ali? Afro-Asian name. Did you hear Akbar Mecca? Did you hear Malik? No, you didn't hear. Did you hear Malika? But Dr. Chinwe M.A. Awolelu? No, you didn't. You didn't hear that. You heard Niger Congo. That's what you heard. You hear Niger Congo. You don't hear Nilo Sahara. You don't hear Afro-Asiatic. You don't hear Koi or San. You don't hear Austronesian. You hear Niger Congo. At the University, senior lecturer in the Department of Religious Studies, University of Abidjan, Nigeria, Dr. Joseph Omosani Awolelu. If you're the senior lecturer, you have a PhD in the Department of Religious Studies, and you didn't change your name to Muhammad Ali. That's a big influence on me, and that's a big influence on all those because of the Arab slave trade, the East African slave trade. That's an influence on them. That's an influence on all of us who are in the Western Hemisphere because of the West African slave trade, the transatlantic slave trade. That's a big influence on all of us and on other people around the world. That's a big influence on them. Another paper, Introduction to the Study of African Traditional Religion. This paper was written by Dr. T.F. Jimurai. Department of Religious Studies, University of Edo Ekita. Edo Ekita, that's in Nigeria. Did you hear Nilo Sahara? Did you hear Afro-Asiatic? Jimaraya, that's Niger Congo. Department of Religious Studies. Did you hear Malik? No, you didn't. No, you didn't. This paper here was written by Julius Mutugi Gathogo. What that sound like? Do that sound like Afro-Asian? Do that sound like an Austronesian? Do that sound like the Koi, the Sand? Do that sound like a Nilo Sahara? That's Niger Congo. Because Dr. Julius Mutugi Gathogo, the University of KwaZulu, Natal, Pietermaritzburg, South Africa. That's in South Africa. That's Bantu land. Another paper, the study of African traditional religion and its challenges in contemporary time. Rotimi Williams Omotoyi, Department of Religions, University of Ilorin, Nigeria. Rotimi Williams Omotoyi. Do that sound like a Nilo Sahara? In Nigeria, do that sound like an Afro-Asiatic? In Nigeria, no, that's Niger Congo. Rotimi Williams Omotoyi, Department of Religions, University of Ilorin, Nigeria. It's in Nigeria, the African nation of Nigeria. The paper he wrote, the study of African traditional religion and its challenges in contemporary times. And another writer of a paper, Emerging Key Issues in the Study of African Traditional Religions. And the professor that wrote this, Christopher I. Ijazu. That's Nilo Sahara. That's Austronesian. That's the Koi Sand. That's Afro-Asiatic. No, that's Niger Congo. Ijazu. We're finna really get this point across about African traditional religion. When you teach and give instruction in African traditional religion, when you study, when you learn African traditional religion, the professors that, you know, teaching and giving instructions, when they tell you their name, you should listen to the name that you hear in the Department of Religious Studies, because they teach Islam in the Department of Religion. They teach Judaism, they teach Christianity. You understand, in the Department of Religious Studies. Dr. John S. Mbidi. Dr. John S. Mbidi. You know, when you pronounce his name, Mbidi. He was born in Kenya. And then he studied at Makerere University College. That's in Uganda. African nation, Uganda. Then he went on to study at Barrington College, Rhode Island. That's here in America. Then he obtained his doctorate in theology at Cambridge University. Then he served in an English parish and as a business lecturer in Birmingham and at the University of Hamburg in Germany. And since 1964, he has taught at Makerere University College. And in 1968, he was appointed professor of religious studies. He was appointed the professor of religious studies. So, Dr. John S. Mbidi. What's his name? Dr. John S. Mbidi. And what book did he write? African Religious and Philosophy. Do you see the name Muhammad Ali? Do you see the name Hakim Jabbar? Do you see the name Malik? No, you don't hear that. You hear Dr. John S. Mbidi, and he has a book. He earned his doctorate in theology at Cambridge University. Well, he had earned his doctorate in theology, and he never did change his name to Muhammad Ali or Hakim Mecca. You understand? Akbar Raheem. Something like that. He obtained his doctorate in theology at Cambridge University. And go down, it says, in 1968, he was appointed professor of religious studies. Of religious studies. Now, when you say religious studies, that does not exclude Judaism, Islam, Christianity, and other faiths. Dr. John S. M. Beattie. Dr. John S. M. Beattie. This book here was written, this West African traditional religion. And the writer of this book, Kofi Asari Opoku, Opoku. And it tells you on the page that he's a senior research fellow in religion and ethics, Institute of African Studies, University of Ghana, Legon. That's in Ghana, the African nation of Ghana. Did he change his name to Hakeem Akbar? Did you hear that? Did you hear all that Afro-Asiatic? Did you hear some Rastafari stuff, some Hebrew Israelite? No, you didn't. You hear Kofi Asari Opoku. That's Niger Congo. That's Niger Congo. Okay, this is another book, West African Traditional Religion, T.N.O. Kwakwutombi. Now, it says here on the inside, T.N.O. Kwakwutombi, Oyo State College of Education, St. Andrew's Campus, Oyo. That's in Nigeria. And he also said this. The reason for him writing this book, listen to this. To all those who believe that the growth and development of our indigenous traditional African religion will lead to the social, economic, and political emancipation of Africa. Indigenous traditional African religion. Did you hear Judaism? Did you hear Christianity? Did you hear Islam? No, what did you hear? He said, to all those who believe that the growth and development of our indigenous traditional African religion will lead to the social, economic, and political emancipation of Africa. Who said that? T.N.O. Kwakwaponi. He wrote the book, West African Traditional Religion. Did he change his name? No, he didn't. His name is T.N.O. Kwakwaponi. So, on that note, we're going to conclude on today's video. But on our next video, we're going to continue to talk about African traditional religion. And again, I want to say thanks to all my fans and my support for your continued encouragement and support. And until our next video, I wish each and every one of you best. Take care of yourself. One more. Why get on the mark? I doubt. E the logic, I doubt. Next video.